Good afternoon, everyone. It's another beautiful Wednesday lunchtime, and we hope na nag-enjoy kayo sa inyong lunch. Malalo kayo mag-enjoy pagkasama niyo kami dito sa Health Revolution. And good afternoon, Ma'am Betty. Kumusta?
Yeah, good afternoon, Raymond. And once again, happy lunch to all our viewers of Health Revolution. And as usual, we will bring you a very interesting topic today, which we will call lifestyle medicine. It's a relatively new branch of medicine wherein people can be proactive with their health. And today we have with us the very respected Dr. Linda Lim Barona of Adventist Medical Center. One of the pioneers, actually, ang Adventists, they're well known for their naturopath leaning, di ba? Medicine practices, yes. In terms of food, in terms of, you know, life. Yan na nga, kaya nga sila din yung proponent ng lifestyle changes. Mm. And so, good afternoon po, Dr. Verona.
She is the head of the Lifestyle Medicine Department mismo ng Adventist Medical Center.
Good afternoon sa inyo.
Thank you very much. Salamat. And very, very busy po kayo, and you took a special time out to join us today. Mm-hmm. Eh, kasi ho, yung show ho namin, it's about it's health revolution. Revolution means change. Hindi naman yung magre-rebelde.
Magalit sa inyo si President.
Now we are clarifying it right now. It's a green revolution, and it's a basta health lang po.
It's walang a change
in lifestyle number one. Kaya po, we're so honored to have you here. We're going to talk about lifestyle as our medicine.
Yes, correct. Yung so, lifestyle, doctor, yeah.
Opo.
Sige, so, tanong
doctora,
na lang
can
muna.
You tell us more? Oo, can you tell us more what lifestyle medicine is all about?
Ang lifestyle medicine, it's a relatively new specialty. At ito ay naging dahil sa pangangailangan. Kasi dahil sa buong mundo for the past, let's say, since ilang taon na, no, since mga early, siguro late 80s, nagsimula, or during the 1980s, ay nagsimula na yung mga lifestyle diseases or yung chronic diseases. Pero palagi ko meron na din to noon, pero yung as a worldwide problem, doon medyo talagang nagsimula. At so mga 2004, the doctors from the US, and I do believe pati yung mga ibang internationally, they got together and they formed the American College of Lifestyle Medicine. At sila yung nag-umpisa ng movement na to, lahat ng tao, hindi lamang doctors, pati yung mga basta stakeholders about healthy lifestyle, they made it into an organization. And from there, nag-branch out na to at meron na tayong international under the umbrella, International Board of Lifestyle Medicine, yung mga iba-ibang countries, alliance, global alliance in lifestyle medicine, ay nag-form na rin. Kaya dito sa Philippines, we have the Philippine College of Lifestyle Medicine. Kasi ang lifestyle medicine ay hindi lamang preventive, pero ito yung evidence-based na treatment or approach to the management of lifestyle diseases. Ibig sabihin ng evidence-based, proven by science, back up by research na etong ginagawa ay talagang eto, proven ito, may study. Tapos, bukod dyan, ay tinuturuan din ng lifestyle medicine. It empowers the patient, the people, the person concerned. Kasi pwede nga ito backup ng studies, pero kung hindi naman empowered ang mga kinauukulan, they will not effect the change. Kasi revolution din to eh. Talagang, I think, very up. Kasi it's really the things that are recommended in lifestyle actually is going back to the basics. It's yung root, addressing the root of the problem. And the advice na ginagawa is going back to the basics, but we have gone so far in our, the way we treat disease, the way we approach, at saka yung mga tao, yung perspective sa sakit ay medyo nalayo na. No? They go to the doctor, they want their problem to be fixed, they want their diseases to be fixed, pero they don't think of that they need to change their lifestyle. And yun ang ina-address natin sa lifestyle medicine.
So parang lifestyle medicine, it's like parang coaching siya, coaching the patient on so what should they do so that they will be able to overcome their diseases, di mo ba?
So yun, isang part yun, yung part. Coaching, no? Educating, coaching, lahat talaga ng magagawa mo to equip the patient ay ipoprovide.
So very, it's a multiple approach. It's a multiple
approach. And so very important with lifestyle medicine is the cooperation of the patient himself. Kasi kung kunyari, sabihin ni doktora, ito gawin mo. Ay, hindi naman siya. Sabi ni doktora, matulog ka ng 8 hours a day. Ayaw naman niya. Gusto niya 5 hours a day lang. So, syempre, there's magkakaroon ng problem, di ho ba?
Business Innovations Gateway Incorporated. Our vision, to provide happy options for healthy living the holistic way. Our mission, to manufacture and distribute innovative and convenient high-quality products which provide the best value for your money. Our products: Gusto Powdered Vegetable Drink Mix, Big 5-0 Plant-Based Omega-369 Vegetarian Capsules, 2 Biota Liver Care Probiotics with Prebiotic Vegetarian Capsules, 15 Biota Probiotics with Prebiotics. Presenting, Gusto Powdered Vegetable Drink Mix. By using spray drying technology, the vegetables are naturally spray dried. Gusto Powdered Vegetable Drink Mix is your daily detox with all natural antioxidants. Gusto Powdered Vegetable Drink Mix combines the natural goodness of 10 vegetables, ginger, turmeric and mango, healthily sweetened with stevia leaves which are easily absorbed by your body. You can now enjoy the health benefits of daily fruit and vegetable intake without the added work of chewing. Moving on to Big 5-0 Plant-Based Omega-369 Vegetarian Capsules to flush out the bad oil. Big 5-0 has 5 ingredients that can prevent cardiovascular disease. The capsule of Big 5-0. improved capsule stability and effectivity. Japan Ceiling Capsule Introduction. It is a vegetable capsule and uses an advanced Japanese sealing technology, so the oil do not leak. This way the capsule can be easily digested. Reduces water vapor infiltration, that leads to the reduction of moisture deterioration of the raw material. Moving on to 15 Biota. Unique features of 15 Biota probiotics with prebiotics. Contains 15 strains probiotics kept alive by prebiotics. Each capsule have 5 billion alive bacteria with innovative coating technology. Move on to 2 Biota Liver Care Probiotics with prebiotic vegetarian capsules. It filters our blood. Help yourself. Take 2 Biota Liver Care. It is the smart vitamin.
Classified as lifestyle diseases.
Okay, magandang tanong. Ano, yung mga lifestyle diseases are itong mga chronic diseases natin. Sa top 10 causes of disease, top 10 causes of death in the Philippines ay nasa top yung mga lifestyle diseases. No? Number one, heart disease. Pangalawa ay stroke, tsaka yung mga cardiovascular diseases. Then we have cancer. No, and then we have yung mga chronic lung disease dahil sa smoking, and then we have kidney diseases, we have diabetes. Yan yung mga primary cause ng lifestyle diseases.
All of these are related
lifestyle related.
And also what we put inside our bodies.
Tama, yun, so, habit.
So doctora, COVID-19 is not considered a lifestyle disease.
No, it's an infectious yan. But there is a relationship.
With lifestyle, pero si lifestyle medicine, they can help prevent the patient or the person from catching the virus, di ba?
What lifestyle medicine can do is to strengthen the to help no strengthen the immune system, tsaka to help the people to have a healthy lifestyle. Kasi kung pakikinggan natin sa mga news at tsaka sa mga incidences, sino yung mga taong at risk for COVID, hindi ba? Yung una, yung mga exposed, kaya yung mga healthcare workers or yung mga nasa crowded areas. Pangalawa, ano, yung mga extremes of age, yung the very, lalo na yung mga elderly, no? At saka yung may mga tinatawag natin na concomitant o comorbid, merong underlying na disease, yung mga obese, yung mga may diabetes, yung mga nag-chemotherapy, yung bang syempre meron silang ibang sakit na nakakapagpalala or that makes them prone to COVID-19.
So mahina yung immune, yung kanilang immune system to fight the virus. Okay.
Yes, tama.
Doktora, kasi I am a DOH licensed, certified naturopath, practitioner lang naman. So that's what I have always been telling people. Sabi ko, you know, with this COVID-19, ang kailangan lang naman is wear your mask, wash your hands, and boost your immune system. Kasi sa akin, para sa akin, no, that is the best defense that you can have, diba? Di ba? Kasi kung malakas mo yung immune system, kahit na anong virus yung aso, kailangan labanan mo.
Kaya kahit nga, tama. Pag papakinggan natin yung mga sa news, sa mga, yung mga interviews, at yung mga advices, always nahandun healthy lifestyle para lumakas yung ating panlaban kasi wala tayong definite na gamot para sa sakit na to, kundi lakas, palakasin natin yung panlaban natin.
So in from the lifestyle medicine point of view, ano po ang pwedeng gawin ng mga tao to at least prevent or to help them not catch the COVID-19 virus? And if ever they do, parang di ba sa yung itong sa COVID-19 is dapat at the first sign of a symptom, alam na ng tao kung ano ho yung dapat niyang gawin, di ba? Kaya feeling ko lang kasi yung iba ho namamatay kasi hinahayaan ho nilang lumala yung mga condition nila, or dahil maybe hindi ho nila alam kung ano ho yung gagawin nila, or pwede din ho na yun na nga, usapin nga ho ninyo, may mga comorbidities, so yun yung medyo mahirap din labanan. Pero kasi ho, di ba ngayon, right now at this stage, they are saying that the health workers, the doctors, they already know how to treat the disease in a kaya nga ho, dapat huwag na rin ho masyadong matakot ho yung tao. Kasi nga ho, yung tao, pag natakot ho, inunahan ho ng takot, baka yung chances of survival is also lesser, di ba?
Correct, so, tama.
Oo. Kayo ho, what will you suggest ho? Ano ho ang magandang gawin ho ngayon ng mga,
siyempre, bukod
as prevention na rin.
Yeah. Bukod nga dun sa sinabi mo, kumbaga yun ang mga primary prevention, ano, yung mga wearing mask, mga keeping yung sanitation, ano, no, yung environment clean. Yun ngang paano natin palalakasin or iboboost yung ating immune system. Unang-una ay kung tayo ay merong sakit na itong mga chronic diseases na to, may high blood, may diabetes, or tayo ay extreme yung weight natin, obese tayo, or may sakit tayo sa puso, or na-stroke tayo, i-treat po natin yun, ano, gamutin natin, i-address ng maayos through lifestyle changes din ang magko-contribute dyan, di ba? Tapos, ang kasunod ay pag na maganda ang control natin, tapos yung ating lifestyle, yung ating changes, no, ay ini-implement natin, ay ano yun, yung parang automatic, no, our body will heal itself. Kasi itong mga underlying diseases na to, ay it has something to do with inflammation or low-grade inflammation. Kaya kung kasi dahil nga dun sa mga ang karaniwang ugat niyan, yung sa maling pagkain, tapos kulang sa exercise, and then too much stress, lack of sleep. So, i-address po natin yon, ano? At ang unang-una, syempre, yung nutrition. I-improve natin yung nutrition, no? By improving your nutrition, and sa lifestyle medicine, talagang very highly recommended is to have a plant-based diet. Balikan natin yung mga tipo ng pagkain, yung mga ninuno natin, yung tipo ng pagkain bago pa dumating itong mga westernized lifestyle, no, yung food. Yung pagka, yeah, yung food nila, yung mga sa likod bahay or sa palengke, hindi, walang supermart, walang mga processed food, kasi usually when you go to the supermart or you go to mga ano, yung mga syempre naka-shelves dyan, processed. But if you go to the parang kung ano yung tinitinda sa market, sa palengke, alam natin yan, yung mga whole foods, no, na natural or plant-based. And then, if we do that, unang-una, yung ma-address na dyan yung mga hypertension, diabetes natin, ano, yung mga cholesterol dyan na matataas. Kasi we will be eating what is anti-inflammatory. Pangalawa, yun nga, babawasan natin yung kung ano yung mga nakakasama sa atin. So, ibig sabihin, eating more of what is healthy, what we need to eat, and eating less of what is harmful to our body. And what are the things that are harmful to our body? Yun, too much fat, yung mga saturated fat, which comes from animal meat, and too much sugar, no? Ito yung sa mga processed foods, sa mga soft drinks, sa mga pastries, sa mga cookies, and then too much processed food or refined, highly refined. So wala nang fibers na natire. And they found out na we have friendly bacteria in our gut, in our colon. Ito yung mga friendly bacteria na pagka tayo ay kumakain ng mga hindi natural food, mga processed food, mga highly oily, ay nawawala sila kasi they thrive on mga fibers, no? Yung mga gulay natin. Pag yan ang kinakayaan tawag sa mga gulay na yung mga green leafy vegetables, yung mga, basta itong mga gulay natin maraming fibers, ang tawag yan ay prebiotics. Kasi yung probiotic, iniinom na natin yung bacteria mismo. But if we eat this kind of vegetables or plant food, yung prebiotic, siya yung nag-enhance ng friendly bacteria, and you know they produce short chain fatty acids. Itong short chain fatty acids na to na pinoproduce ng bacteria from the food that we eat, it helps control or it helps address yung mga inflammation that is going on in our body. It helps our weight control, it helps yung pati yung mental health natin na apektuhan, pati yung mga sa lungs natin, pati yung sa mga buntis, sa mga fetus, and then pati sa bone marrow natin, tinutulungan niya na mag-produce para siyang raw material to produce yung mga panlaban natin sa katawan to fight, no? To fight against mga foreign invaders. And then, okay, so yun sa food pa lang yun, ano? And then what else are we going to address in the healthy lifestyle? Yun na, sinabi ko, exercise. Kasi ang tao ngayon, we have been used to just sitting down, lalo na ngayon, ang mga kabataan, no? I pity them kasi puro virtual, and even us, virtual, na we just sit down and then face and ano, and our children also, dati dapat nasa school sila, nagtatakbuhan, naglalaro, at saka bawal lumabas, so you just confine your children. So medyo talagang challenge itong panahon na to. Ano pa, yung ating nga, yung rest natin, we need to rest daily to have a good night's rest. 8 hours sleep is very good kasi doon nagre-repair yung ating katawan. To help repair our body, napoproduce yung mga antioxidants at yung mga free radicals dyan, nilalabanan nila. So that is with rest. And then we even have circaseptan. Katawan natin, 7-day cycle. We need to rest 1 day a week. Oo, kaya hindi talaga maganda yung trabaho, walang rest. Kailangan i-break natin yung cycle na yon. Yeah, what else? Yung social relationship. Kailangan i-develop natin yun, ano? Hindi tayo masyadong isolated. That's why very high ang incidence ngayon ng depression and anxiety. Kasi although we have social media, pero hindi face-to-face yon at nagkakalayo ang mga family, no? That social relationship. And of course, we have to address smoking, no? yung aspect na yon, yung mga bad habits, alcohol and smoking.
Given an active life in and out of my dental profession, because of Gusto powdered vegetable drink made me more strong and energy regained. Well, because of this Gusto product, having a busy practice with lots of energy loss, I regain it very well and I can start my day right and I can regain a better lifestyle ahead of me. Thanks, Gusto vegetable drink.
doktora, hindi ito yung kaya yung ginagawa natin. Doesn't take the place of actual meeting people.
I should think so. Talagang kahit although we are interacting, pero yung social ano, kasi syempre ang nag-uusap lang tayo kung what if we have audience, kahit friends are there, they cannot talk then, di ba? Hindi ka makakapag-usap, unlike when you are in a conference na may social relationship. Talagang medyo ano ang social relationship natin. Although I think there's an personally dito sa lockdown, kasi yung social relationship namin sa family medyo na nurture kasi nandyan kami lahat sa bahay, so kami sama-sama. Pero there might be some family na kahit nasa sama-sama sila, baka mamaya kanya-kanya silang gadget, no? At hindi na rin nag-uusap, nalang ganun. So,
ang napansin ko lang, one thing good is, ano, kasi kagaya namin before, syempre we work, no? We work so hard. And then at least yung ngayon, we eat together dinner. Kasi may curfew or you have to go home earlier. So at the minimum, you're able to ano, to have dinner together as a family. And I think a lot of families have been experiencing this eh. Sabi nga nila, yeah, mas closer na. Parang nagkaroon ng bonding yung ano, yung family.
Totoo.
Kaya sabi
nila, yan.
Back to basics.
Tama, back to basics. And for me personally, kahit sa family namin, we had our spiritual strengthening, you know, we have family worship together, yes, in the morning and in the evening. Kaya talagang medyo natuunan namin yan. Kaya spiritually, spiritual health is also important.
Tsaka mas ano, no, parang yung tao ngayon, mas they cling to that, ano, they become more spiritually healthy. Kasi para, they feel there's a need. Alam mo naman mga tao, magdadasal lang yan.
Totoo yan.
So, right now, at least they see there's a need, so they pray. And well, prayer is really a very powerful thing.
Correct.
You know, sa exercise ko pala, kasi nga we're within, sabi nga nila, okay, I will walk to in the four walls of my room. Di ba okay lang po yun, nalakad ka lang, ikot ng ikot, as long as you walk, so it's still exercise, di ba?
Yeah, correct, tama, no? Ang advice is 150 minutes a week of moderate exercise. So medyo ano na yon, medyo parang medyo mas ano yung pagka yung more than walking yon. But if you walk naman, like let's say hindi mo kaya yung mga like Zumba or yung mga aerobics, no? That's kasi 150 minutes lang yon, that can be 30 minutes a day for 5 days. Pero kung hindi mo yon kaya, you can do the walking na, kung gusto mo, brisk walking, ubra. Pero kung yung usual walking mo, at least 10,000 steps a day. So that will take mga, depende sa pacing mo, mga 1 hour, yan. No, you can have your counter sa cellphone, pedometer, you measure it, and that will be good enough then, yung 10,000 steps a day.
I remember before there was a diabetes. Sabi niya, kasi ano noon eh, nung time na yun, pre-diabetic yung husband ko. Sabi niya, you walk for 30 minutes after you eat. So
correct.
You burn the calories that you took during that ano, that meal.
Yeah.
And if you walk longer for like an hour, then you burn some of your stored fats or calories.
Correct.
Parang ganun. Tama ho siya.
Tama. Tama yung kasi pagka kumain tayo, lalo na kung ang kinakain natin yung medyo highly refined, no, kahit nga hindi matamis, or it's a very high fat, oily food, ang sugar natin will also be affected. Tapos ang yung mga refined, mga heated food, it will cause a surge in our blood sugar. So if you walk right after eating, that will help na hindi siya tataas ng bigla, hindi magsesurge. And that's why when we advise plant-based food or yung mga maraming fibers na pagkain, ang sugar mo ay hindi tumataas ng kasing taas ng refined foods or mga processed.
Doktora, considered ba exercise yung maglikpit ng bahay? Mag-ayos-ayos ng mga gamit?
Well, that is better than sitting around, no? That is better than just sitting. But siguro, depende sa extensiveness. Kasi kung medyo nakaupo ka lang din, pero kung ikaw ay nagbubunot ng sahig or nagwawales, nagsasampay, or medyo ano, so yung activity.
Yeah. So at least pwede schedule ng mga tao yung mga ganyang activities after they eat. So doktora, so in this time of COVID, so ano ho yung pwede ho ninyong ma-advise for people para what should they do when they feel that they have the symptoms? So what are the symptoms ho ba ng COVID-19?
Okay, ang pinakakaraniwan na symptoms ng COVID-19 ay syempre yung unang-una nilalagnat, tapos nawawala ng parang pang-amoy, tsaka yung nawawala ng panlasa, tapos inuubo or sinisipon or sore throat. Yan ang pinakakaraniwan din. May mga tao na nag-ELBM, tapos masakit ang katawan, tsaka yung medyo pinakamatindi, yung nahihirapan ng huminga kasi yung oxygen nila ay bumababa. So, syempre, ang first nating sasabihin is avoidance, no? Even more than before pa. Now is the time na more than ever, we should be aware na pwedeng anybody can have the disease or maybe carrying it. Yung parang medyo praning ka ng kaunti para yung pag-iwas mo, no? So, parang do not let your defenses down. Always wear your mask and then always disinfect your hand, no? As do not touch your face. Kung naging habit natin na medyo magkamot ng ilong, tapos siyempre na i-inconvenient tayo with the mask. So, what we do is we keep on adjusting. So, kung let's say may nakausap kang tao, nandyan yung virus sa mask mo, and then you touch it, and then di mo naman nilinis yung kamay mo, later on, you wipe your face or it get on your things and then napuna sa mukha mo or nalanghap mo yon, then you can have the infection. So, yun yung una. And then, once you have symptoms, huwag ninyong yung baliwalain. Just may mga hotline tayo na nilalagay ng DOH, we can call. And huwag nating parang sadyain pa, parang nanghahawa pa tayo na parang lakad pa rin tayo ng lakad as if nothing is happening. So, medyo distansya na tayo or just keep ourselves protected para in case na baka carrier na nga tayo, we don't know, then at least ma-save natin yung iba.
Kung baga ho, mag-isolation na ho, mag-quarantine na po, di ho ba? And yeah, I think or, government has...
Tsaka kung alam natin talagang kung alam nating na-expose tayo, medyo mas aware tayo, there's that possibility. Pero huwag naman yung sobrang, parang nandidiri ka na sa lahat ng tao or di ka na talaga lalabas. But then, parang medyo timplahin din.
May mga first aid ho ba na pwedeng gawin? Like, kasi sabi ho nila, you can drink more warm water. Kasi when you drink warm water, you will tend to sweat and 'di ba our skin ho kasi it's a gland wherein the toxins can come out of our body, 'di ba?
Yeah, I think it helps a lot, no? That's one thing also. We need to have lots of liquid and instead of taking mga juices, drinks, soft drinks or yung mga processed or sweetened drinks, let's take water kasi it's a very good cleanser. It's a general cleanser outside and inside, no? Yung ating mga makina sa katawan natin, it works better pagka tayo ay fully hydrated. So, hydration is very important.
Very. How about po yung kasi I read somewhere that the COVID-19 is a fat lipid. So I would advise people, sabi ko, you gargle with the VCO or you gargle with MCT oil. Would that help?
Wala akong data na ano dyan. So we really cannot say. Although may mga studies sila before, diba, sa SARS-CoV. I think, who was it? Dr. Dairit, yung matandang Dairit, was studying on the effects of VCO. May antiviral property siya. But I don't know with regards to this type now. Kaya hindi ko din masabi kung good or not.
Anak, anong gusto mong juice?
Ang gusto ko, veggie juice, kasi...
Gusto juice, gusto ng lahat. Ang veggie juice, nang papasigla ng katawan. Nasa gusto na ang lahat. May gulay na, may prutas pa. Itadan na ang sustansya. Vitamin ay kompleto.
Ikaw ma, gusto mo? Uminom na ng isang baso ng sustansya. Kompletong sigla para sa ating pamilya. Gusto Veggie Juice, your yummy veggie drink.
Kung puso ang problema, break the bad habits. Move on na para sa healthy heartbeats. A big 5-0. Tara na! Let's all be fit. Mega healthy sa Omega 963. Para sa heart nutrient deficiency. Sa big 5-0, strong ang heart and body. Sa big 5-0.
Nakamove on ka na't kumanda? Sa big 5-0, puso mo ay alagang-alaga.
Ikaw ba ang may problema? Dahil sa bad bacteria, mayroong solusyon para sa'yo. Huwag mag-alala, subukan mo na, para may good digestion ka. Ha ha, happy life sa 15 Biota.
15 Biota,
para laging masabi ako dyan.
In terms of food ho, ano ho yung maganda hong ano, kasi palagi sinasabi ko, you know, the Philippines is a very lucky country na, you know, we have the very cheap malunggay. Diba yung malunggay, gawin lang na sabaw, it's already very good for the health of the people, di ba? So kung baga, hindi naman market mayaman ka, then you can afford malunggay, kahit na yung may hirap, they can afford malunggay, so there is no reason for you to get sick, di ba?
Tama yan, ano? Kasi hindi na natin ipapangarapin yung bibili pa tayo ng mga pagkain na mga imported or yung mamahalin. Pero yung mga pangtangkong, talbos, ng kamote, yung malunggay, na anywhere you go, yung mga tindahan dyan, kasi ay maraming tindang gulay na yan, ay napakaganda sa ating katawan, no? So, ibig sabihin, kaya pagka ang maganda niyan, binabariety natin yung ating kinakain, ikot, no? Like, hindi lang puro kangkong, or hindi lang puro sayote, or hindi lamang puro repolyo. Usually, the higher the color, the darker the color, ay yun yung mas healthy.
Kasi they have ano yata eh, they have toxic, they are also ano detoxifiers, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
dark green. So nako, you know, alam mo Raymond, I would like to have a longer talk with Dr. Barona kasi
we will schedule it. We can
a lot of questions pa
mga. Pasyente na yata naghihintay
ka. Oo nga.
Thank you so much for being there in the front lines.
Thank you.
Sa inyo mga frontliners. And also for taking time for us for this short talk. And please keep safe. By the way, meron po kayong gusto i-promote or meron kayong gusto i-share before we wrap up?
Yung tungkol dito sa mga sinabi ko, if they want to understand it more, meron kaming daily program ng Adventist Medical Center Manila Facebook page. Every 10 to 11 in the morning, may live stream kami. Lahat ng mga topics on healthy lifestyle and other diseases ay pinag-uusapan. So you can also watch the videos there. Ayan, I think you're showing it. And we also have a radio program, 12:30 to 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Nasa Facebook din yan. And then sa DWBL, 12:42 sa AM band at saka sa Adventist World Radio. It's a short Adventist band.
Okay.
Ayun. So, salamat sa inyo.
Non-limited power. So, thank you very
Thank you very much and God bless everyone.
Thank you very much. Po. Stay safe po, Doktora.
Sige po. Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
And guys, it's a wrap. So don't forget to, if you want more information about lifestyle medicine, it's a Facebook page ng Adventist Medical Center. And that's it for now. Ma'am Betty, see you again. So,
we'll give the people a short video to watch after this.
Yeah. Okay. So guys, you can watch this on demand anytime you want. This is Health Revolution on our pages. Go check it out, guys. Health Revolution PH and My Big Inc. at Edge TV Philippines. Thank you so much.
Next Wednesday. Thank you, Raymond. Thank you to the audience.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
The menu uses a big wellness products. Great and beautiful skin. Drink a glass of Gusto veggie juice 3 times a day. The 10 leafy greens in Gusto helps detoxify and nourish your skin inside out. With antibiotics. When you are taking antibiotics which kills all the good and bad bacteria, take 2 capsules of 15 biota after 2 hours to bring in the good bacteria. Happy Eco to you. Constipation. Take a glass of Gusto veggie juice with 1 capsule of 15 biota in the morning and in the evening until your bowel movement is regular. Check the quality of your poop. 1 solid strand in light to dark brown color, and most importantly, it should be floating. Diarrhea, or LBM. Take a glass of Gusto veggie juice with 2 capsules of 15 biota. Then 2 more capsules after 2 hours. There is actually no overdose to probiotics, so you may take 1 capsule every 4 hours till your gut is cleansed. Slimming her fasting. Drink a glass of Gusto veggie juice for dinner, or when you are following the 13-hour fasting for a good body cleanse. Taking Big 5-0 helps flush out the bad oils and contributes to heart health. Skin eczema. Take 2 capsules of 15 biota in the morning, and 2 capsules of 15 biota in the evening. May also take together with 2 Biota Liver Care capsules. Testimonials. Before. After 2 weeks. Then, after 1 month. Before. After 2 weeks. Then, after 1 month. Energy. As Dr. Ricky Gatbenton, the past president of the PDA Laguna chapter, testified, Gusto veggie juice energizes him and enables him to accomplish his work and civic activities the whole day through. Drink more Gusto and less coffee. Hangover. To prevent hangovers after a drinking bout, drink a glass of Gusto veggie juice and 1 capsule of 2 Biota Liver Care. For heavy drinkers, maintenance with 2 Biota Liver Care 2 to 3 times a day is recommended. Urine flow volume. Take a glass of Gusto veggie juice at least 3 times a day. It makes you pee more. helping you alleviate prostate concerns. Dengue, as Talb as Nanka noted, can help in increasing the platelet count. Drinking a glass of Gusto also helps increase platelet counts. It is convenient, easy, and delicious. Insomnia, drink a glass of Gusto 1 hour before bedtime to help you sleep well. This condition, however, applies to some people only. For children, one capsule of 15 biota during the first 5 days of every month helps in improving gut flora, thereby improving appetite and digestion. For children between the ages of 1 to 4, this practice is especially helpful as they tend to put everything into their mouth, increasing the chances of acquiring E. coli. For the sick and elderly, we highly recommend you take the whole wellness package, which consists of Gusto vegetable powder drink, Big 5-0 and 15 biota, or 2 biota liver care probiotics with prebiotics. Our products are halal and FDA approved. Follow us on Facebook at My Big Inc. at Gusto Juice. At bspotph. You can also visit us on www.mybiginc.com. info@mybiginc.com. For more inquiries, you may call us on 661-482-3 470-8953 0917-713-2457 0999-991-6123. Have a healthy and happy life, everyone.
Through your Qigong movement. Now, here I'm going to show you. So you clap your hands 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then use your right hand to cup the elbow, this part, 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And do the right arm, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then use the right hand to cup the armpit of your left arm 9 times by putting your hand behind your head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And do the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then repeat 8 more times, total together 9 times. Make sure you cup, right? You don't use your flat palm to hit, that hurts. When you cup, you use the vibration to go deeper into the tissues. Use the vibration to help to open up the channels. In our hands, we have 4 energy channels, meridians, connecting directly to the heart. They're all in the hands. That's why clapping the hands, clapping these areas, it can help to enhance the circulation of the heart. If you don't have any heart problems, by doing so, it can help to prevent any heart disease. If you do have challenges with your heart, by doing it, it is very helpful. And just recently, I have one lady friend said, you know, she has an irregular heartbeat. By doing this movement for 7 days, 2 times a day, and that problem disappeared. The best time to do this movement is at noon, between 11 to 1 o'clock. Other than that, you can do it anytime. So enjoy it. If you like what I share with you, please share with your friends. And don't forget to give me a like. Looking so forward to seeing you until next time. Thank you so much.